What up, y'all? Forward Fabian, man, back with a video for the channel. I'm doing a reaction that just announced NYC starting to evict migrants, man. This is from NYC Uncovered. Migrants now to receive services, man. Eviction services? Duh. Anyways, bro, be sure to like, comment, subscribe. I'm doing several of these reactions, man. I'm going to continue to do them, too. So, hey, comment down below any thoughts, any feedback. Let's get into the video.
You won't believe what's happening to migrants in New York. This is the biggest deportation spree the city has ever seen. There's been a surge in gang-related crimes in New York City lately, and the city is finally addressing its migrant situation. However, not everything is set in stone, because there's one factor that could still disrupt this new policy, and his name is Joe Biden.
New York City is evicting 3,500 migrant families from the shelters where they are currently housed. The New York Times reports families who've been at the shelters.
They say that like he a whole problem, like he a whole disease. What's the word I'm looking for? Like he a whole cancer. Say it's the Joe Biden problem.
60 days will have to reapply.
New York City is set to begin the process of evicting migrant families from city-run shelters.
Now three fewer homeless encampments in the city.
As the city continues to look for places to house migrants,
shelter system has been at the breaking point for months.
Since spring 2022, New York City has set up a widespread system of emergency shelters and temporary tent communities to accommodate tens of thousands of asylum seekers who have arrived seeking assistance over the last 2 years. Currently, more than 64,600 asylum seekers are residing in emergency shelters managed by the city. These shelters include repurposed hotels and large tent-like structures.
I'm just curious to understand like how migrants pick where they kind of like migrate to, you know what I'm saying? Like, do they go to places where they think they have family, or do they just go to places trying to find any opportunity in America, right? Because why go to New York? New York's just a city that lives on top of itself. So it's like, it's a city stacked on top of a city, bro. I don't know. It's just heavily crowded, claustrophobic, you know, dog eat dog world. You know what I'm saying? So I'm thinking like, bro, I'm going to go somewhere more spread out. I'm not going to California. You know what I'm saying? We ain't trying to come across, what's it called? Skid Row, you know what I'm saying? We ain't trying to be out in the streets like that, but go to Texas or something like that. Open land, you feel me? Open space.
Designed for housing. The asylum seeker population consists of single adults, adult families, and families with children. They are located throughout the city's five boroughs, although their distribution is not uniform. Manhattan and Queens host a larger portion of asylum seekers in shelters compared to other boroughs, with approximately 38% and 31% of all asylum seekers, respectively, as of March 3, 2024.
In his statement, Mayor Adams said, "The right to shelter was never intended to apply to a population larger than most U.S. cities descending on the five boroughs in less than 2 years."
In the wake of New York City's decision too much, too fast to evict migrants from their temporary shelters, a new crisis has emerged. A recent discovery of two illegal shelters, housing over 100 asylum seekers, has revealed the dark side of the city's response to the migrant crisis.
For the second time in 2 days, the NYPD has uncovered an illegal makeshift migrant shelter.
Inspectors from the Department of Buildings responded to a call on a Wednesday afternoon regarding an alleged illegal conversion at a two-story commercial building in the Fordham neighborhood on East Kingsbridge Road. Upon arrival, they discovered that one of the stores within the building had been turned into unauthorized sleeping quarters. The inspectors uncovered a concerning scene inside. On the first floor alone, there were 34 beds, and in the basement, they found another 10 beds tightly packed together. Moreover, they came across extension cords, e-bikes, space heaters, and hot plates on both floors. Due to the hazardous conditions,
these fools was finessing the heat, they was finessing the Wi-Fi, the electricity, all that, getting the cord to attach to another cord spanning about 15 to 20 feet. Yeah, man, we gotta always find some satire and everything, bro. Calm down. Quit getting too serious, bro. Relax. No, that's crazy, man. That's tight living quarters, you know what I'm saying? 10 bunks just side by side. Do what you gotta do, man. The people gotta live, people gotta eat, man. I'm just wondering how do police come across these illegal bunkers or whatever they call them, man. These illegal places to where they find a lot of these migrants, you know, housing themselves. Like, what do they get tipped off? Do they look and see a lot of people going into one building and, hey, let's check out and see if they actually, you know, this is actually a lawful residence to be able to house migrants in. I don't even know what kind of certifications and codes you even need to be applicable. You know what I'm saying? But it sounds like it's a whole process.
...found inside, including severe overcrowding, lack of natural light, and ventilation issues.
Lack of natural light. So see, these are some of the parameters you need. Bro, nobody care about light. If I got a place to lay my head where I sleep, why am I caring about the light? Ventilation, yeah, you need ventilation, bro. But I would stay in a closet for all I care. You know what I'm saying? If I'm not on the streets, just going hungry for no reason.
The DOB issued a vacate order for the building, citing life-threatening circumstances.
Natalie, talk to some of the neighbors out here. They'll tell you this was no secret. Migrants often spotted coming and going every single day.
That's
officials from the city's Office of Emergency Management responded to the situation, coordinating efforts to address immediate needs and possibly referring the affected individuals to asylum seeker services if required.
Mm.
Later that evening, some of the migrant men who had been residing there were spotted gathering their belongings and loading them onto a bus. One of the residents mentioned that they used a nearby gym for showering, highlighting the challenges they faced in basic living conditions. Local residents were aware of the illegal shelter, with one neighbor revealing that the occupants paid monthly fees ranging from $300 to $600. According to them, conditions in the basement were particularly dire, lacking basic amenities like toilets and bathing facilities.
How much was he charging them?
I think they said $300, some say $600.
Damn, so they be finessing. Some of them get won over, right? It's not an authorized facility to house migrants, then two, you making profit, right? And you're really running up the numbers to where it's not even really affordable or even understandable how you could be charging that, bro. No real right living conditions, no ventilation. You know what I'm saying? Y'all ain't got no light in there. Y'all got nowhere for people to shower, to wash their hands, wipe their booty hole. It's like, that's damn near savage conditions. If anything, bro, you should just be letting them eat, stay there for free. You know what I'm saying? Or at least cut that in half to like 100, 150 a month, something like that. Bro said 300 to 600 to not even be able to take a shower, wipe your ass, take a piss, or see the light of day. Duh, that's just ludicrous, bro.
Landlord received two violations, one for failing to maintain the building and another for using it in a manner inconsistent with city records. Interestingly, this landlord had previously operated a similar illegal shelter in Queens. Inspectors found that the commercial space and cellar had been converted into sleeping quarters, with 14 bunk beds and 13 beds crammed into these areas. Plumbing work had been done without permits, and there was a lack of proper exits, ventilation, and natural light for the occupants.
It was yesterday's raid in Queens. It now brings the total number of migrants to more than 100, all housed in two separate commercial businesses owned, investigators say, by the same man.
Abu Sarr, that boy was a migrant himself who owns a furniture store, expressed empathy for the residents, most of whom hailed from his native Senegal. He recounted how he reluctantly began offering them shelter after the city restricted the duration that single migrants could stay in official shelters.
This is the situation. This is what we're trying to avoid.
The duration.
Out there in this cold weather.
But y'all got way too many parameters out there for asylum seekers. You know what I'm saying? Like, why is there a limitation on how long they could stay? So you have to go from shelter to shelter? Somebody need to print off all the details, bro. All the bullet points. I need to take a look at these, bro, because they ain't making no sense right now. Well, you need to be showering every single day. Well, you need to pretty much be able to have this much. You know what I'm saying? Like, at this point, I don't even know what I'm saying, bro, because hypothetically speaking, it seems like they just listen off all these mandatory rules and requirements. So, well, you gotta have if you're under 5 foot, you can't stay at the shelter for more than 30 days. It's like, bro, what are y'all what are y'all talking about?
Shelter came to light after a neighbor raised concerns about e-bikes parked near her property. This prompted FDNY inspectors to look into the matter, revealing a situation that had been operating for months unbeknownst to many in the neighborhood.
DOB issuing two violations to their landlord. They say also operated an illegal migrant shelter at a furniture store in South Richmond Hill, Queens.
Worse still, it has been revealed that the city is paying millions of dollars to pay slumlords to convert some properties into shelters, despite the inherent risks.
Slumlords.
Not only does this put migrants in danger, but it also raises serious ethical concerns about the city's priorities. A once-empty brewery building located at 133rd St. in Gowanus is undergoing a transformation into a 400-bed homeless shelter. This initiative is led by real estate investor David Levitan, who has been associated with allegations of poor building conditions in the past.
What? As
indicated by Department of Building.
Man, that's not the dude you want representing that whole project. I was about to say, shout out to this dude, man. He actually doing something back for the city and the community, but then he's known for, you know, putting up buildings that have, they're unstable, so to speak. He's not following any procedure. What a fraud.
Buildings permits and city records.
Gowanus residents said they're not only concerned about the impact the proposed shelter could have on the neighborhood, but they say it's too close to a toxic Superfund site and is unfit for anyone to live there.
Levitan,
you know what I'm saying?
A prominent figure in the
New York for you.
Shelter scene, has previously faced scrutiny over property maintenance and business practices, as posted in a 2021 New York Times investigation. The building, a former factory situated at the intersection of 3rd and Bond Streets, was originally zoned for manufacturing purposes. In 2018, it was listed among the Gowanus structures that locals sought to preserve as landmarks. However, nearby residents are now expressing concerns about the lack of community input regarding Levitan's conversion project.
Damn, no, they're saying he got no feedback from the community. He just did what he wanted to do. No insight from the people that live there.
Questions have arisen regarding how the conversion of this building into a homeless shelter was approved without more extensive consultation with the community.
Who cares?
The local turf war.
We don't know how this was approved. We're in dire need of additional shelters. But how is this? Like, what is y'all complaining about?
For the city controller, Brad Lander, strips Mayor Adams of his emergency powers to approve contracts related to the migrant crisis.
Late 2023, Mayor Eric Adams lost the ability to award emergency contracts without following the usual competitive bidding process. This change came after a medical services provider, DACO, came under scrutiny for allegedly providing spoiled meals to migrants under a no-bid contract worth $432 million. Additionally, the state has pointed out that the city has not utilized available sites across the five boroughs, like convention centers, armories, racetracks, and college dorms, capable of housing up to 3,000 people. Currently, more than 70,000 migrants are being accommodated across these boroughs.
Why does it always seem to be some type of narrative to where New York don't really know how to use their resources properly, bro? Like, he just named X amount of buildings to where it's like, I don't know, I guess these things take time to where the turnaround isn't happening like this, bro. If you got space, use it. Y'all streets will be a little bit nicer, a little less dirty. I mean, the streets is naturally dirty, but then you got all these migrants and folks just laying outside and waiting to get access to the next shelter. It's like, but you got all these buildings to be able to accommodate, and y'all just over here, well, y'all fingers up y'all ass.
The Department of Buildings issued the permit in November for the conversion of the commercial building
on
133rd
Street. Let's make this quick.
To a transient lodging house featuring 16 sleeping room accommodations with a total of 400 beds along with associated offices.
There you go.
But during a recent visit, there was no evident activity at the location, though neighbors have noticed workers inside installing drywall partitions in recent days. According to a spokesperson from the Department of Buildings, the proposed use for transient accommodations and hotels is permitted in M1 districts. The permit specifies that the shelter will be managed by a philanthropic or nonprofit institution, sponsored by the Department of Homeless Services, and the certificate of occupancy will be discontinued once the shelter ceases its operations.
The city's Department of Social Services says Bragg's Home Care Corp will provide wraparound services and case management for residents. It says with more than 178,000 migrants in the city now, quote, additional capacity is desperately needed.
A spokesperson from the Department of Homeless Services has confirmed that BH Rags Home Care Corp, a home health care provider, will oversee operations at 133rd Street. And the site is scheduled to open in the summer of 2024.
Yeah.
A recent letter from the Housing Preservation and Development Office, part of a permit application, reveals that Beach Rags Home Care Corp. has secured a 9-year lease with the building owner. The Department of Homeless Services declined to comment on the city's financial arrangement with the nonprofit for running the site. Bragg's Home Care Corp. plans to maintain 24-hour on-site security and establish a round-the-clock hotline for community concerns. They are dedicated to ongoing community involvement regarding the emergency shelter. Local elected officials and community leaders were informed several months in advance about the shelter.
If you ask the majority of people, they might support it, but the people who are actually going to meetings and who have the time to organize and go to those meetings, they're the ones who are more vocal about it, and they're the ones who might be rejecting.
Now, if you are wondering why this project is receiving so much backlash, here's a little backstory. In September, 133rd Street Owner LLC, represented by Yosef Rabinowitz, purchased the building for $19.5 million from longtime owner. HFK Inc. Levitan's Liberty One Group shares an address with the LLC, and Yosef Rabinowitz, also known as JoJo, is a partner at this company. Levitan is identified as the building's owner in documents accompanying the Department of Buildings permit application. Both Levitan and Rabinowitz have faced numerous complaints from shelter residents and tenants
fishy.
Over the years.
I already knew it.
Levitan was listed on the Public Advocate's Worst Landlord Watch List.
See, I was fishing it to these folks that just... So, let's leave it at that. Them boys fishy, bro. They up to no good.
Last year, the city canceled plans for a shelter in the Bronx owned by Levitan after significant community opposition, as reported by the city. This year, Levitan has faced legal action twice from the Housing Preservation and Development for failing to provide hot water to tenants in two different buildings. Additionally, there are accusations against Liberty One related to lead poisoning cases in buildings where children were affected, according to court documents. Bragg's Home Care Corp., which was given $24 million by the city in mid-2023 to manage five shelters, has also come under scrutiny.
They probably blew all that money.
The city reported that residents at a Bragg's-run shelter in Sheepshead Bay fell ill due to spoiled food.
You know what I'm saying?
Leading to multiple emergency rooms.
These fools cutting corners and stuff like that. You know what I'm saying? They're accessing spoiled food to get to the migrants. You know what I'm saying? Like, why am I not surprised by that? Oh, let's give them the spoiled trays. It's only a couple months off. It's not a big deal. You know what I'm saying? Like, bro, you got a $24 million. You got $24 million budget from the city, and you cutting corners by giving spoiled lunches out. Greed is real.
Room visits for children and adults. A spokesperson from the Department of Homeless Services assured Brownstoner that the incident was uncommon and promptly resolved.
Bruh, shit was done on
they
purpose.
Emphasized that safeguarding residents' health and safety and addressing challenges with rapid shelter expansions are top priorities. So, if the government knows all this, why is it pressing hard on this decision?
Harlem residents are accusing the city of using the bait and switch tactic on them. They tell us what was built as a luxury apartment building almost 10 years ago is now being turned into a migrant shelter.
Now, this is another
okay,
hot topic debate in the Big Apple.
Might as well be.
Also boils down to the surge of migrants.
It's well, about this abandoned building is being turned into a shelter now. Y'all ain't doing nothing else with it.
Migrants.
I feel he sounded so despicable. He sounded so disgusted. He said, well, this building is a migrant center. Shut your punk ass up, right?
They're actually turning this into a sanctuary for asylum seekers.
The building near 130th Street was initially designed as a luxury living space with amenities like an indoor swimming pool and marble bathrooms, where residents paid market rates for a comfortable lifestyle. However, it has remained vacant for 10 years due to foreclosure on the developers. Mayor Eric Adams recently proposed converting this building into a shelter for newly arrived migrants. But this plan faced strong opposition from community members like McDaniel, who feel Harlem doesn't need another shelter.
Bro, these stupid ass politicians, bro. I'm telling y'all, man. Same folks can make detrimental decisions for your community, your society, bro. Be the ones with their head up their ass, bro. We don't need another shelter. I would love to see a long list of reasons why y'all wouldn't need another shelter. So you'd prefer to have migrants just all over the street and just turn New York into Skid Row. Is that what you're trying to tell me, Mr. Daniels? Or is your head too far up your ass?
McDaniel emphasizes the urgent need for
affordable,
income-driven housing in the area, expressing concerns about how children in the shelter would integrate into the community and attend school, given the temporary nature of the shelter environment.
No, I don't agree with if it turned into a sanctuary for asylum seekers. No, when we have people right here that need the space.
Following community backlash.
Asylum seekers know when we have people right here that need the space.
She said people right here that need the space.
Following community backlash, the city reconsidered and decided to repurpose the facility to provide shelter for families in need from New York City.
This is my thing, right? So when the need arises due to the migrant crisis, that's when it's shot down to be used for a migrant facility or shelter. But I'm sure the people of New York City have been starving, being homeless on the street for, they said that building was vacant for 10 years. There's a lot of homeless folks who've been out on the street for several years, bro. Oh, but when the migrant crisis comes about, nah, let's not help these other folk. Let's not help these asylum seekers who are literally escaping for their lives, majority of them, right? Let's help out our local New Yorkers that we never cared about for the last 5 years. But oh, if we're gonna put it up against the migrants versus local New Yorkers, man, let's just give it to the New Yorkers, man. They suffered long enough. Let's give that building to them. You know what I'm saying? How like when people in need force, like people have always been in need, bruh. So when other people come in need and they're not native, it forces society or the government's hand, so to speak, you know, the city's hand, so to speak, to say, hey, guess what? We don't need to help these people. Let's help our own people for once. We know we need. You know what I'm saying? Like, what? Bruh, the clown world. That's the logic. We can't help migrants. Let's start focusing on helping our fellow New Yorkers, even though we never gave a damn about helping them back in the day. But if you're going to have a migrant sized up against a New Yorker, I'm helping a New Yorker any other day. That literally what it sounds like their logic sounding like right now, bro. I mean...
I know what's going on here. We're not moving folks into a brand new building when you have long-term needs into a community. That's not going to happen.
Despite this adjustment...
So I'm saying, those long-term needs in the community been going on, Doug. So why is it now a spectacle? Just because you got migrants and they need to put them somewhere. Our community's had needs for a long time now. While you got Biden sending all this, you know, our political figures and head leaders sending all X amount of millions and dollars to all these other countries around the world. But you said they've been in need, right? That's what I'm saying. This is the clown world we live in, bro. And it's not even just the world, bro. America's a clown world.
Community members remained discontented with the idea of turning the building into a shelter. However, not everyone in Harlem opposes the concept of establishing a shelter at 2201 Adam
Clayton
Powell Jr.
Been vacant for 10 years. Do something with it.
A local pharmacist who has owned a nearby pharmacy for nearly 12 years,
fellow African,
believes that homeless individuals in Harlem could benefit from another shelter option. The Department of Social Services is now exploring the possibility of using the building for permanent housing placements for individuals who currently rely on the city's shelter
system. Y'all better think quick, man.
The agency reports an increase of 17% in placing shelter residents into permanent housing.
Oh, wow.
Reflecting ongoing efforts to address housing instability in New York City.
Oh, wow.
Too many homeless shelters in this community.
So, here's what we have been able to make out of this
situation.
It's
the people homeless, bruh.
New York City's response to the migrant crisis has been chaotic and ineffective. The city's leaders have been contradictory in their approach.
Yeah, facts.
Requesting that migrants leave the temporary shelters while also creating new shelters that may not be safe or suitable. In the process, they have exposed migrants to criminal activities and health risks. The result is a crisis that is not only putting the well-being of migrants at risk, but also undermining the city's reputation as a place of refuge. Ultimately, the lack of a coherent plan has only worsened the situation, and it is time for the city to rethink its approach.
What else is new, bruh? What else is new? These fools is clowning, bro. Y'all's leadership is lacking. You know what I'm saying? Across the country, across the states. It's just cornballness, corniness, bro. I ain't got nothing else to say no more. Just watching this video just heated me. You know what I'm saying? Just be frustrated, bro. That's what I want. Bro. People want us to tap into politics and all, man. Man, forget your politics, bro. With that being said, comment down below, man. Let me know y'all's thoughts on this one in the comment section below. Peace, love, God bless, man. Everybody out there struggling, keep y'all head up, man. Stay prayed up. You know, God got y'all, man. I pray for everybody going through a tough time. It's not even just migrants, man. The homeless folks that's on the street, you know, y'all had a building vacant for 10 years. And then when the migrant crisis comes about or something, you know, y'all just now start considering solutions for the natives there, the native New Yorkan. You know what I'm saying? It's just like, what? We out, bro. Catch y'all next time. Peace.